At the end of this module, you should be able to perform algebraic computations with scalars and employ order of operations to perform calculations. Let's look at an example of problems you may encounter in this Engineering 132 class. Here you're asked to compute the natural convection heat transfer coefficient, which is H, in units of watts per meter squared Kelvin from air at a temperature of 100 Kelvin, known as TA in the equation below, to a cylindrical surface at a temperature of 500 Kelvin, known as TS, using the experimentally derived equation given here. It is always a good engineering habit of mind to verify that our tools are working as we expect them to. The first thing we therefore want to do is perform our calculations by hand. Notice that order of operations, as you know from algebraic calculations, becomes important in this calculation. We want to perform the operation in parentheses first. We plug our values into a calculator and obtain the result shown here, where the natural convection heat transfer coefficient is now 9.14 watts per meter squared Kelvin. Now that we know what value we should obtain, let's look at how to use MATLAB to do this calculation. Let's begin by typing out the equation as we saw it in the previous slide. 1.24 times 500 minus 100 raised to the 1/3. We'll push enter. This error is telling me about parentheses, but they look okay. Sometimes the error message is indicating the first thing MATLAB cannot interpret, so it was not expecting a left parentheses. I haven't told MATLAB I want to multiply 1.24 by the temperature difference. Let me try an x for multiplication. I can easily pull up the last equation I typed using the up arrow in my keyboard. We'll push enter. MATLAB doesn't like an x for multiplication. I will try an asterisk next for the multiplication sign. I'll push enter now so that we can see what answer we get. So I'm getting a value now, but not the correct value. Let us note that we now know that multiplication in MATLAB is performed using the asterisk symbol. But let's try and figure out why we are not getting the correct answer. I would like to call your attention to the equation we have typed out. MATLAB uses a defined order to perform operations which are similar to typical math order. The manner in which it is displayed here, the order of operations will be as follows. The parentheses will be evaluated first, followed by raising the quantity in the parentheses to the power 1. Since multiplication and division are operations that MATLAB gives the same priority, the order of operations will be from left to right. The multiplication will be performed, and finally a division by 3 will be performed. Take a moment to think about whether this is the order of operations we want. So this is not how we want MATLAB to evaluate this calculation. We need to perform the 1/3 operation before raising the quantity 500 minus 100 to the power. We will therefore put parentheses around the 1/3 operation to manage the order of operations. Now we see that this will yield the correct value because the math order is now 500 minus 100 followed by 1/3, with the leftmost parentheses getting computed first, then raising to the power, and then multiplication. One last thing to note here is that even inside the parentheses, if we have multiple different calculations that are being performed, the calculations are performed using the typical order of operations. In this case, we had two sets of parentheses and each had just one calculation that needed to be performed within them. Now that we have seen what simple calculations in MATLAB look like, here is a summary of the order of operations. parentheses always take precedence over any other mathematical calculation, followed by raising a quantity to the power, then a negative, followed by multiplication and division, and finally addition or subtraction. Looking back at our example, we see that the parentheses operations are performed first. However, since there are two sets, it calculates within the left set first, then the right set. Next, it evaluates the exponent, and finally the multiplication. Always remember that MATLAB goes from left to right on any operations that are on the same level. Let's look at a brief summary of this algebraic operations module. We need to be able to perform algebraic calculations using correct MATLAB syntax. We need to pair all parentheses whenever we're performing our calculations. We need to manage the order of operations at different levels using parentheses. We need to include all terms required by the problem. Finally, we need to verify the result using an alternative to MATLAB whenever appropriate. In this online module, for example, we showed that you would work the solution by hand before trying it out in MATLAB.